So, have you been exploring project management tools and come across a software called Asana? Well, it's a well-known option in the market, producing a high-quality project management experience that you and your team might just be needing. And in today's video, we're going to overview the full application to see whether it's suitable for you and your team. So, let's strap in, dive into the application and features, and see whether it is a good option for you guys out there. Today's video is kindly brought to you by Zapier. A little bit more about them later in this video. So I think it's important to understand what Asana is, if you're somebody that doesn't know what it is. Well, it's a project management software. They call themselves a work management platform that allow you to do a wide range of things. So for example, you can traditionally plan your projects in here, you can create dashboards, but you can more recently build reports, manage workflows, and use AI to save you and your team time. The application wants to be your work management platform and encompassing all elements of that. So there are a few alternatives to Asana out there, like ClickUp, Monday.com, even Trello, that are popular solutions. And if you're hunting for more project management tools, I'd highly recommend going over to toolfinder.co to explore all of them if you're in that research process. So now we've got this out the way in terms of what Asana is. Now, how much is Asana? Well, the pricing is here on screen. It is obviously subject to change, but the application prices itself between $10 to $25 per user per month for access, and naturally it is more premium in terms of the options that are out on the market currently. Okie dokie, so here we are with the web version of Asana. You can also get it on mobile, but primarily this application helps you to organize your tasks in a lot of different views. So in this video, I'm using the advanced trial. This one's available for individuals and small teams, and it's priced around $25 per month. This includes some of the workflow features, Asana AI, advanced reporting, and resource management, which we'll come to later. But largely, the experience in the free plan only includes list, board, and calendar views. So I'll be showing you all of the different views that include the likes of timeline and Gantt view. So now we've got that out the way. As you can see, this is what Asana looks like when you land on the project. And when you get started, you can build the project with you. And this is what the project will look like. You can monitor the description here. You can see whether your team are on track, which is a really nice feature. Now, as I mentioned, there are some AI features baked into the premium and the advanced pricing. And they include elements like this, project summaries, and also task summaries, as well as smaller generative AI features, which can be helpful across the application. They also have something called Asana Studio, which allows you to monitor how AI can help you save you time. But we'll talk about that a little bit later in this video. So as you can see, you can add project roles here. You can also connect goals. Goals we'll come to in a bit. But the overview area is essentially trying to be the place where you see everything that's happening in your team. Even an activity log over here, adding a due date if that's suitable as well, to give you an idea of what you need to focus on and the objectives in mind. So you can organize your different workload as part of lists, which is a great way to just simply add tasks and see it as a collective view. You can add a field here using the gallery that it gives you a wide range of options like priorities, and you can also create new fields as well, which is a helpful way to break things down and make it more personalized. You can even begin to assign stuff to other people, choose the assignee, and also change the due dates, much like you would with other project management solutions. Now there's a grouping function, and there's an options area in which you can modify some of the details in using it like a database. Now there are some additional abilities like boards, and as you can see, calendar view, which is part of the regular pricing, but you can naturally access both of these and manage what you've got on your plate. But the real place that you manage your own tasks is an area called My Tasks. And this way, you can see anything assigned to you across a wide range of different views that's personalized to you. So for example, if you are in the premium pricing and beyond, you will get access to things like dashboards and the ability to add other views. And you can add more views if you do find it suitable for the different projects that you're working on using the filters. Now, going back to this home view, you can organize the majority of your work through here. This is a great way to see stuff that is working on in your team. So things you're assigned, goals that you and your team are working on, or things that are overdue. This is almost a dashboard for your own focused work and all of your teams as well. There's even an Asana mode as well for AI, giving you an idea of upcoming priorities for the week and things like that. You just need to activate it, and that's only available through the Premium Plus pricing. So jumping back to the different list views, you do have the ability to see see a dashboard. A dashboard is part of the premium plan and onwards and gives you an insight into all the different projects that you're working on. But most importantly, you can add widgets and charts, which can help build different experiences for you. So it's really a way to build these that is most suitable for you using filters, sorting, and the widgets. Now, I mentioned the calendar and the board view, but you can also organize in timeline view, which is a great way to see stuff at a glance. You can narrow them down to hours and even go all the way to days, years, half years, and everything like that. As you can see, this is a really helpful view for extending activities if you find them suitable, and also modifying the views and saving them as a new tab, which is very helpful. You can also modify how the project dependencies work as well, which effectively makes this a Gantt view, which can be incredibly helpful. But if you're looking at a more powerful Gantt view, there is a dedicated option, and this is much more suited for tracking dependencies and baselines in a typical Gantt structure. Now, it is also really nice and well defined, allowing you to really go into the detail that you would with a Gantt chart. Now, there are additional views as well. For example, you get this note view where you can add meeting notes or even ideas that you've had, but this is a collaborative environment that you can share with other people. You can also create tasks as part of this and add much more details in terms of formatting and options, which is why a lot of people like the note view and use it as a partial documentation platform. But there is another view called workload view, and this is really nice if you've got lots of team members, because you can see how many tasks certain people are working on and make sure your team aren't overloaded, in particular on these days, and making sure that you are keeping track of how much they've got on, which is a helpful resource management function inside of Asana. Now, these are all of the views that you do get, and if you've already got one, you can add two views, which is helpful. So if you've got multiple meeting notes or multiple boards, you can use this view to add more, which is great, but just remember, it can get a little bit overwhelming. Now, up in the top right-hand corner, you can customize your project, and this helps you add things like task templates, apps, and things like that, which will help to enhance all of the automations that you have. But this could be a great time to show you how automations work, and this is where you can access the workflows function as part of Asana. And essentially, you can connect up things like form submissions, task templates, and also from other applications, so that anything that is activated can begin to work in a workflow. And I'll show you some demonstrations of what that looks like on screen now, and in terms of how useful it could potentially be. Ever wanted to automate things, but you lack the coding skills? You can now do that with Zapier with no code. Zapier is the leader in automation, allowing you to take your workflows to the next level with a suite of automation tools. You can go from an idea to reality in no time, setting up triggers for simple workflows and for even more advanced ones. That's why over 2.2 million companies use and trust Zapier. And thanks to Zapier for sponsoring this video. So we talked about a few of the different features like reporting. Well, reporting can be a great way to see all of the practices that you are doing as a team. And it looks very much similar to the dashboard function. And that's because it is. You can modify these dashboards and essentially these reporting functions to see company-wide progress, particular employees, or you can see the progress of sales by connecting up additional widgets that are external to the likes of Asana. You can also use something called goals. Now, goals are great for breaking down particular company goals. You can have company goals, strategic maps, and you can even have team goals as well. And these are all broken down, and you can see this view as a way to organize all of your goals and how they correlate to each other. Now, for example, if I click into a goal, you can update the status and see the progress as well. And connecting up the sub goals will help you to make these more approachable for you and your team. But if you and your team are looking for something a little bit more zoomed out, this can be a great way to do that. And for many people, it is a really easy experience as well. Now, as you can imagine, there are some AI features in this app. And we talked about one earlier called Asana AI, in which you can ask questions here. Now, for example, you could ask something like, how do I add work to Asana? But the AI assistant comes up as a pop-up box in the bottom right corner. You can also access it up here as well, which means you can see such details and ask requests. For example, I could say, what is there to do today as a general idea for what I need to do for work today. And it will respond and collect your answer using their AI platform. Now, this is helpful for being able to see what I need to do for the day, and it'll bring back the relevant stuff as well as the indications of priority level it has. So you can search across all of your different tasks, projects, portfolios, and much more as part of Asana. And you can use that search really easily up at the top. Up here, you can also create a team, a goal, a message. And a message is a good way to let your team know of certain projects you're working on. Now, this isn't necessarily a chat platform, but it will give you an opportunity to share an update with your team, and this will appear inside of the inbox. The inbox is a great way to see stuff that has been assigned to you or is a message that your team is updated on. So each project has a load of different functionalities. For example, you can set up a color and an icon, as well as loads of importing functions, syncing functions with Google Calendar and all the other calendar apps that you can imagine, and a wide range of views. So you and your team won't be without a lot of the functions that you're expecting in terms of customizing it to how you want and how you look. So hopefully you can get an idea for that Asana is a pretty powerful platform. The application is easy to use and works well for those who want a reliable, easy to use experience. Now, if you're somebody as a team that is looking for something a little bit more inclusive with documents, with chat-based functions, then it might be worth looking at some of the alternatives over on Toolfinder. But largely, Asana does really well at planning and focusing on the project management aspect of things, and it comes in a really high quality package. The design isn't necessarily something that's changed over the last few years, but they do update routine features. Over on their YouTube channel, they share routinely what's new, and it is actually a decent channel for summarizing content that is helpful. So hopefully that was a useful guide to Asana, and hopefully it helped work out whether it is a go-to application for you. Asana is easy to use, functional, and a good quality project management software. And if you want to download it or check it out, you can find it out, link in the description. So thanks very much. I look forward to helping you with more tools and resources, and I hope that you have a fantastic day ahead. Cheerio for now.